Hello, this is the RPG Chick. Welcome back to Let's Play Obduction. Blind, yeah, we still can't go through there. I would like you to beg my pardon. I did check a walkthrough once again. Just because I wasn't sure what to do next. We're not done yet in that stone and gear, giant gears and levers and stuff. That world. I missed a spot to go up. Yeah, we got stuck here and we... See that? Rotating thingy. Now I can go. Oh, that was weird. That was a very weird glitch there. Whoops. So I have to go back there. Yeah, let's go this way. Whoops. See, I missed a spot to go up, and I know there's two things of importance. Two more things to go through. Ambassador seeds, I believe they are. I don't know what's through them. I really just check out the minimum and then see what I can figure out for myself afterwards. And I'm also realizing that we turned on... Apparently we turned on the power. We got the electricity running. But not the water. We still have to provide water from there. And then we have the other world to go to too, which is this door we can't go through, so I'm guessing after that we'll try to figure that out. Anyone passed? Actually. No, I can go right in here. So if I go from here, I'll be stuck in a little area. We've been in there. Whoop, whoop. So I need to go... It's not in this house, is it? It's in here. Oh. Bye-bye, folks. So I need to go back where I was, which is through that sphere. Frame rate hits. Okay. The great machine is working fine. Let me just see something. Oh, I can't get down from this way. I get stuck on this. See, I don't want to be on that, but I think... Well, I have to go up and around, don't I? This thing we can move. I think that's where I want to go, is back this way. Mm-hmm. Not sure. Been here. Right, okay. Pardon me, guys. Yeah, this is completely a dead end, so okay. Beg you guys' patience here, because it's not here, it's back where you were then, it must be. There's stairs going up. And I need to take them. It's just that this place is so complicated to travel around. Maybe we need to go... come out there? Oh, those stairs, maybe. Get down there. Really impressive seeing all this machinery in motion. I just... you know, I'm not sure if this is it. I think it's back where we activated the machine. This place is like a maze, trying to find your way through. Wait. Have I been down here? I might have. I know, yeah, I think I've been down here. We're looking for a giant, like a skeleton. And if we see that, it's not a human skeleton. If we see that, we know we're on the right path. Okay, this comes up here. Okay, so we can get to this side. Got it. Wondering if this can be activated in some way. Maybe that's a lever? It's kind of hard to see. No? No, it just looks like a... I don't know. Yeah, there's another one here. Okay. Yeah, maybe this is nothing of importance. Interesting, though, you'd think that it would go... up there, and then maybe could provide access to this way here, but it's broken off there anyway. So, I don't know. Oh, that's what we're looking for, I think. I think. Unless that's the way we came in. I'm so lost here. And they got these seeds all over the place. I wonder what the meaning is there. So we got all these stairs. I'm just looking around before I go up any of them. That's a dead end. Cool theme. I like it. Oh, another way up. Look at that. I think it would be cool if you actually fall off. That would give it a greater sense of realism. So it would make this area more challenging, this whole world. Okay, so we got stairs up going over there. And so we got these two stairs, and this leads up to also same area. And we've also got stairs here. Stairs there. Oh my god, there's all these areas. There's a passageway there. This place is so huge. Oh, I can hear things going down the pipe. So besides that passage, dead end here. Okay. Let's see what's through here, keeping in mind that on the other side there's stairs and planks going up. Locked, okay. So we're taking those stairs. we may very end up coming out the other side, because a lot of those doors, I mean, it looks like it's barred from the other side, like a lot of those doors are on Earth, or Hunrath, rather. Alright, let's take this way. This must be the place. Whoops. So this place has fallen into disrepair, but people have, you know, patched it up somewhat. So you think you're far above the earth, but there's plenty of ground and trees. I mean, outside doesn't really even look like mountainous areas that much. Here it is. Oh, there's one of those flying things. Oh, that is that the Ori, the bug race? So we've seen them flitting around in Hunrath as well. Yeah, here they are. And luminous wings. So, new area. Wow. Whatever died here was huge. Alright, so we're going down. Through the rib cage. At least it looks like a rib cage. Oh, wait. Oh! Okay, that works. Does this come out the other side with the door? Of course, we haven't run into anything useful yet. Stairs going up there. That huge chain with the hook there. Awesome. Something else over there. Maybe that might be where we came from? I don't even know. Oop. Let me up. Thank you. We go up more and into this chamber here. Another one of those Abaster seeds, right? There's two of them. They go, I do not know which. The other one is supposed to be up more. Oh. To that green. This is another green one. Goes to that, like, foresty, like rainforest area. It must go there. Been here before, unless that's another door. We came down this way. That might be the other machine over there. Barely could see in the circle there. No, I'm not sure. Well, more probably around the corner. But we couldn't get through this door. Oh. Well, I don't know what digit to make on this. That did it? I swear, guys, I didn't see that in the walkthrough. That did it. Now the other... We go back. The other one around the corner somewhere over there. We can get to from near the junkyard, I believe. And I'm assuming this will bring us back, I'm hoping, where we came from. I just looked at it and figured... They're all connected except for that one. Got me, man. Alright. Well, that was accomplished. I look forward to going back there and seeing what's through that door. But we have some work to do here first. Whole bunch of those seeds. There's that crane. Or whatever. Wait, I came from down there. So the stairs going up even more. Which is good because... Oh. The stairs going down as well. What's down here? We'll check down here. Can't forget that stair is going... Here's another one. Alright. me just see where this goes. Remember, take two flights of stairs up from here. Sometimes it's really good I'm recording because... Hope my voice isn't cutting out because I'm getting frame rate hits on this stuff. We always do. Because I go back and I reference these videos. That and me saying this stuff out loud. Don't forget to come back and go up the two flights of stairs. Just saying it out loud helps me remember. Where are we? Back in Hunrath? Bunch of seeds here. Paintings? Paintings of that other world. Or at least that one is. Looks like the others may be the same. What's this? I can literally play that harp. That's awesome. Books? Wait. That's interesting. I can look at all this stuff? Also, looks like a compass on the back. Who are you? And your little teddy bear friend. 2E on it. Someone likes little figures. They are pretty cool. Looks like they're from the 60s or 50s. I want to wind it up. I can't wind it up. I literally can't wind that up. That's sad. You are cool looking indeed as well. Awesome. Reminds me of, except for the eyes, reminds me of Dwemer machines from Skyrim. Or Elder Scrolls in general. So this looks like one of those old fortune teller things. There sure is a lot to look at here. Cool. He's looking all over it in case there's like codes or something. I still don't know what to do with that machine. That device. I called it a device. There's a book there. And you have this stuff, look in here. The device back in the giant chain world. Awesome picture. What can I do with this? I can open that. I can close that. I can open that. I can close, I can turn this. I have to keep turning the mouse. Sounds like the theme, one of the themes in this game. Okay. It looks like there's nothing. Huh. CJ. CF. Catherine Foley? Or Carolyn Foley, rather. This is the theme that was just playing. Diddlin. Okay. Just working on this one, huh? WJ or JM. Actually, if you hold it this way, JM. Oh, it's a male and female symbol, actually. I thought I heard a female voice humming out this way. Huh. Not sure. Very, very low. There's more stuff over there. Oh, come on. 15997EH. Now, we realize by looking at these are days after Hunrath, when Hunrath was founded. The Valain, they... I can't find the words. It's such a foreign life cycle. Or perhaps not. They launched themselves across the expanses of space, preserved for eons, until at last their technological arcs can hone in and carry them to a new home. They have no connection with their predecessors, but in spite of this, perhaps because of this, they have amazing recollections of their history. Their stories are epic, reaching back through the eons. Unlike many of us who were abducted, they were abducted as a whole. Their scoop moved an entire facility that was about to be annihilated. I have come to believe that they, perhaps more than any of us, have a deeper understanding of whatever this strange system is that we find ourselves in. 16333AH. So, this is almost a year later. I need to write this down. We buried Ji Yun today. This place never really agreed with her. Kept to herself, mostly. Depressed and downcast. Anyway, I digress. I stayed after the brief words were spoken. I was the last to leave. I wandered to the dome, as I often do, and looked out at the undulating Saurian weirdness beyond the cell wall. Movement caught my eye. Now, on very rare occasions, we've seen Mofang scrambling about in the distance. Okay, so Saurian or Sauria is where the Mofang come from. But there have been fewer and fewer sightings over the years. But before me was a tall, haggard Mofang running desperately, almost directly toward me from one of the distant structures. It, I still can't tell the gender, got closer and closer. I thought it would see me and stop, or turn around, or be curious about the strange dome and our world inside it, but it continued running quickly, almost directly, to my position. I was frozen in place with curiosity until my reflexes took over at the last moment and I leapt out of the way. But rather than hit the dome and fall backward or come through into Hunrath, the dome flashed its familiar tone and the Mofang vanished. I was stunned for a bit, but I retrieved my wits and stepped into the dome myself to quickly get to the other side. After getting through, I immediately turned around and saw the Mofang outside, on the other side of the dome, still running away from whatever it feared, but as if it had no sense of passing around the dome. As surprising as the event was, it did serve to settle a few things in my mind. I always wondered how no one on Earth noticed what had replaced this chunk of Arizona we have here. Yeah, really. What is on Earth that is there now that this place has been carved out and deposited? Like, what's there in its place? I never considered it either. So basically, the thing teleported to the other side of the dome the way we do. And we were able to do that once we disabled the Mofang technology, which was that red beam flashing up into the sky. I'm not sure why we used that thing. I guess because they were locking down And if the Mofeng got in here, it would basically lock off certain areas. Like this, right? Because a lot of these places you can only get to by teleporting. Otherwise, it's inaccessible. So yeah, that was part of their lockdown procedure, must be. Sorry, I'm figuring this out as I'm talking. So 16772 AH. So again, this is like years apart, or a year apart, and change. I've got to vent. Again, there are those who argue with me. Over and over, I demonstrate that in almost every case, whatever the process was that brought us here, it occurred at a pivotal moment. They tell their stories, and they still can't admit that the abduction actually saved each of us. All of us. What is it in human nature that grasps so strongly to the past that we blame our saviors for from stealing it from us? Okay, just one more event before bed. If each of us was individually saved from something, then maybe all of us were corporately saved from something larger? Can we really be sure what's left? And this, the arrivals come from various places and times. Sarah got here almost 15 years ago from the year 2055. Oh, wow. And Uziel got here from 2.5 years ago from 1942. What does that mean? Time here is shuffled and chaotic compared to Earth. What state is Earth in right now? When is Earth right now? 772 AH 787. Okay, so this is not... Oh, wait. 16, yeah, 16787. Alright, so this is like a couple weeks later. It's 3:15 AM and I feel compelled to journal this craziness. After spending most of yesterday meditating with the Arai, and then most of this evening discussing the nature of these worlds with CW, I had just a sip of infamous Hunrath hooch and collapsed in my chair. Well, I just awoke from a dream. I'm not one who puts a lot of credibility in dreams, but maybe the Arai were able to move something in me to understand. Or possibly because of the intense discussion, my subconscious mind was triggered to be able to sort out some logical connections. Or maybe it was the hooch. The dream. I was tending a garden, an immense garden, and it wasn't for food or flowers. It was just about the health of the garden. I kept working and working to control and contain it and make it healthier, but the garden seemed to fight me at every turn. And after what seemed like days of work, I finally gave up in frustration. And as I stood there, doing nothing, the garden flourished before my eyes, growing and spreading in every direction. Because I realized the system that the plants were based on was not about me shaping and controlling. The natural system of plants is healthier when they are out of control, when they are free to spread and intermingle and cross-pollinate and mutate. Now, from a human point of view, that may not provide what I want. I get smaller fruit and smaller flowers and untidiness, but from the point of view of the plants, they grow stronger and much more resilient and resistant. The more they are scattered, the higher their odds of surviving. And now that I contemplate, I realize that even the individual plant's seeds may not appreciate the benefit of what's happening. They are torn far from their origins, forced into situations that seem extreme, possibly even destroyed by these new environments. But for the seeds that survive, the seeds that survive, now that's where real growth, strength, and abundance comes from. It's so beautiful and terrifying. Beyond the beauty of it all is a system and structure that defies understanding. Okay, what if this is all a natural process? There are signs of something behind it all, but well-hidden signs. So, well, if I can look at all of this, the cell, the tree, the water, the seeds, the hub, the health, even the abductions, well, there seems to be a grand system, or plan. The plan doesn't take me into account. It is unemotionally intent on the health of something much bigger. That may hurt my feelings, but, well, What am I in the entire scheme of the universe? I have no idea what, if anything, might have put this process into motion, but that is irrelevant. Tomorrow I will talk with CW. He could be swayed from his battery plan. And we have a yellow line here. 17145 AH. This is a long time. This is like another year and change later. I really don't journal much. No kidding. I came to write this down because I am distraught. As I contemplate the plan that I have set in motion, I realize that I have become the destroyer of worlds. I sat down to write, to seek some cathartic tranquilization, and I realized the last thing I journaled was some esoterically beautiful philosophy about letting this garden grow. Not so reaffirming or calming, but nevertheless, here is my reasoning, because I must write this down. Simply, it's us or them. Complexly, if this is some kind of garden, and we're the plants or seeds or whatever, well, some of us have gotten together and decided that we're the better choice to survive, if the others have unilaterally decided that we all won't survive. I am more fit, damn it. This is not me. I want to be calm and garden or ungarden or grow or... What gives one species the right to destroy another species? Who gets to choose? Do I just lay down and die because the more aggressive species thinks they're better, more powerful? What brutal scale do I use to measure the good of some against the life of others? Does love ever destroy in order to help more survive? To help love itself to survive? Does that even make sense? Can I kill because I think it will bring about more love? What if I'm not even capable of understanding the situation of hate versus love? Maybe I am the hater. Do I generate this love delusion to help me maintain my sanity in light of the choice I have made? My God, it's too much. If these are just my walls of delusion, then I chose to live within them. I am a seed, scattered by the wind, but I will not be trampled. I will kick and scream and survive. May God have mercy on my soul. That's the end.